As Uganda celebrates her 58 years of independence, and most of us are excited about this, we decided to make sure that we engage a couple of people. And here we are at KCCA, where we are going to engage a number of directors at KCCA with the different directorates here to talk about how much KCCA has contributed in terms of the social economic development here. And of course, it's going to be some interesting discussions there to see how much we have achieved. My name is Rowena Kajumba. Don't go away.
Hello, our viewers outside there who are watching us. I would like to take you through our journey as Kampala Capital City Authority through the 58 years, as we celebrate the 58 years of our independence. But before I take you through our journey, please allow me to remove my mask such that you can put a face to the voice. I am Dr. Okello Daniel. I'm the head of the Directorate of Public Health and Environment, and I'm happy to share with you our journey as Kampala Capital City Authority, but specifically as a Directorate of Public Health and Environment, in what we have done in the last couple of years to serve the visitors and the residents of Kampala. As our vision and mission, especially our mission for Kampala Capital City Authority, is to offer quality services. And as Director of Public Health and Environment, we religiously stick to that vision. So what have we done these past couple of years to make sure that we can offer quality services to the people of Kampala? We manage 8 public health facilities in the city, and these facilities are scattered in the 5 divisions of Kampala. We have Kiseni Health Center in Central Division. We have Chitebi and Kawala in Rubaga Division. We have Bukoto and Kiswa in Akawa Division. We have City Hall Clinic also in Central Division. We have Chisugu in Makindye Division, and we have Komambuga in Kawempe Division. These facilities offer a wide range of services, and in the last couple of years, we have renovated the majority of them. We have renovated Komambuga Health Center. We put up a maternity unit, and we also improved on the scope of services. For Kiseni Health Center, we renovated it and improved on the services. You can have neonatal services that we're introducing in Kiseni Health Center. We also have ENT services. It's among the very few facilities in this country whereby a newborn baby can be tested for hearing. Many of us, when a child is born, we take for granted that a child is able to hear, but we only get to realize it much, much later in adulthood. So we can do that service in Kiseni Health Center, and it's actually done at no cost. The other thing we have done, which is very, very exciting, is that we're introducing an emergency medical services for Kampala. We have an ambulance service for Kampala. Many of you may have used it during the COVID period when there was a lockdown. You'd call in and would be able to dispatch an ambulance to wherever you are. Those who are going for their routine appointments, those who had dialysis, those who needed to go to the Cancer Institute, we offered that service. Now, out of that, we're expanding that service. We are coming up with an application, a mobile application, and also a call center where you can directly request for an ambulance. We believe this is a basic service. We believe it's a service that everybody can benefit through. So watch out for this. It will be coming very soon. The other that we have done, many of you may have heard of the Weyonje, the people moving around talking about Weyonje, Weyonje. Weyonje is a flagship project under the Director of Public Health and Environment, and Weyonje in the local language means let's keep clean. So it's focusing on sanitation. It is community-led. What we are doing is advising you on 3 basic things. We're advising that if you have a toilet that is that needs to be emptied, get in touch with KCCA, get in touch with your local leaders. we can be able to connect you to the people who empty the toilets. These are both in the private sector, and we have managed to mobilize the private sector to be able to come to you at a minimal cost. The other thing we are doing is encouraging people to build toilets. And how have we done this? We have trained masons all over the divisions. We have come up with standard plans for toilets and latrines. You may ask, Musawa, I would want to put up a toilet. How do I put up a toilet? What plans can I use? We have made that much easier for you. So get in touch with your local VHT. They will be able to connect you to a manson who will be able to charge you a minimal cost such that you can be able to put up a toilet. The other about sanitation is that we have put up toilets in the markets in the city. We have also put up toilets in schools. And a few years ago, we had a people stance ratio of 1 to 105. Right now, we're having 1 stance to 55. So in 8 years, we have halved the people to stance ratio. And this came from a very touching story. We went to one of the schools, and the head teacher told us that, Doctor, you know, we have students who come here every morning. They come very early to school. I'm used to think that they would come to study. They would want to be the first in class. Unfortunately, no. They would want to come and use the school toilets because back at home, do not have access to toilet facilities. So we picked up that challenge, and we picked it up. We are putting up community toilets that are supposed to be managed by the communities. And these toilets are going to be different. They won't only be toilets, but they will also have a business component on them. So much as you're running, you have toilets below, you can be able to sell airtime by the side, you can be able to do any other business. So we are looking at toilets much, much more different than the traditional toilets that we are. The other that we have done is on garbage collection. Many years ago, you remember KCCA, they used to call us Kasasiro boys, Abatua Kasasiro, and that was an indictment that there was Kasasiro all over the place. Right now the city is fairly clean. We have moved from there, and I would like to thank those ladies who wake up every morning. Those of you who come to work very early in the morning, you religiously see these ladies by the streets, whether it's raining, whether it's not raining, they will always be there from January to December. So I would like to thank them. I would like to thank them for the work they have done. And that is what it means to keep our city clean, and that's a sacrifice we have. So not only are we trying to keep our city clean, but we're also telling you that in garbage, you can be able to recycle the garbage. You don't just be able to throw it away and forget about it. So we are encouraging people to recycle. We're encouraging plastic recycling. We have put up recycling points in various parts of the city. We have partnered with the private sector. So all those of you who have plastics, keep those plastics. That is money, and there are people willing to pay for it. So we're encouraging people to recycle, and this is one of the programs we have actually done. The other things we have done is on air pollution, and that's also a very, very exciting thing we have done. We have put up 25 air pollution monitors in the city. We are now able to tell in real time the quality of our air. 2 years ago, a study came up from WHO that showed that the air quality of Kampala was really bad. It was about 6 or 7 times the normal. So we took it up, the challenge. We have put up air quality monitors such that we can be able to monitor air quality, but also be able to intervene. So we are also going to bring it out for you people to access. So in real time, you'll know what is the air quality in my area, and is it safe for me to go out if I'm asthmatic? What are the things I should not do to spoil our air quality? What we have also done as regards the issue again of immunization, we have put up immunization outreaches. So our teams go outside there, reach out to mothers, and we have our immunization coverage is more than 100%, and you'd wonder why is it more than 100%. That's because Kampala as a city, we have people who come to work, so we increase the population during the day, and during the census time you count people who stay. But Kampala is a business area, so for us, whoever comes into the city, we do actually offer a service to everybody who is there. So among the many things that I would actually spend a day doing, those are the critical things we have done and the things we intend to do. But the things we should look out for a great building coming up in Kiswa Health Center. We are putting up this great maternity unit in Kiswa Health Center. Look out for the toilets that are going to come up along the busy areas in Kampala. We'll put up a public toilet. We'll improve the public toilet that's around the city square. We'll improve the public toilets around the markets. We are also going to improve on the community toilets. Any of you, and we put up a sample of a toilet. If you've been to the new Kasubi market, go there and see the sample of the toilets that we are going to put up. Some of the toilets, we used to talk about double story toilets. Now we are bringing them to Kampala, whereby the lower level will be the toilets, the upper level will be a business. In Kasubi market, what we have done is that the upper level ends up becoming a daycare center. So we are being innovative. Again, what else should you watch out for? Watch out for our mobile app that is coming for you to be able to access ambulance services. Everybody in the former settlements, watch out for that. All that we are doing to make sure that the people in Kampala can be able to get a great service. Lastly, allow me to thank the health workers who have tirelessly been at the front line. The health workers have sacrificed so much. Since March, I don't think they have had an ounce of sleep. Why? Because of COVID. COVID came here in March. COVID is still with us. The numbers are just increasing. I know we are trying our best. We are trying to make sure we observe the SOPs. But let us just try that a little bit more, because COVID is not going to let go very soon. So what am I telling you? Let us maintain physical distance. Let us wash our hands as regular as they are. But importantly, put on that mask. As they say, at least put on that mask for me. Put on that mask for your mother. Put on that mask for your child. Let me end by wishing a happy independence to His Excellency, the President of Uganda, General Yoweri Museveni, and all to the Ugandans outside there. Let us keep safe. Let us stay safe. Let us combat COVID. Thank you very much. As we celebrate our 58th independence anniversary, allow the Directorate of Public Health and Environment in the Kampala Capital City Authority to wish His Excellency, the President of Uganda, General Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, a happy independence. And let me also wish our viewers outside there happy independence, our partners who have supported us all through this, and also the KCCA management team and the Minister for Kampala Capital City and Metropolitan Authority a happy independence anniversary. But as we celebrate, the residents and the visitors of Kampala, COVID is around us. Let us observe the SOPs. Let us follow the President's message. Protect your soft parts. How do you protect your soft parts? Let us put on a mask. Put on a mask for me. Put on a mask for your child. Put on a mask for your mother. Put on a mask for your jaja. Put on a mask to anybody who you love. Let us put on a mask. We are seeing people are not putting on masks as frequently as they are. Please let us put on that mask. The other thing is that let us wash our hands as frequently as possible. Let us sanitize. It is possible that we can prevent COVID. The numbers are going up. Kampala has about 35% of the COVID cases. Why? Because COVID is a disease of movement. COVID is a disease of socialization. COVID is a disease of complacency. So once we get rid of that, then we'll be able to combat COVID. We trust you. We trust the people in Uganda that you know what to do. And we trust you that you care for your life. So let us all protect ourselves against COVID, and let us have a very happy independence anniversary, 58th independence celebration.
Well, there you have it. These are very key issues to look into. And of course, I'm pretty sure most of you are excited about the plans there as well. Well, I do appreciate you for making time with us. It's good to know what we've achieved, you know, accountability. Where have we come from and where are we going? I do take this opportunity to wish you all a lovely, lovely Independence Day.